In today's video, I am going to explain muscle anatomy that attaches to occiput, and I will explain why they are so important. You are looking head from back side. This is right side, this is left side. On right side, I am showing you superficial muscles, and on left side, I'm showing you kind of middle layer of neck muscles. Let me explain this muscle. This is trapezius. Trapezius is big shoulder girdle muscle. This muscle attaches to scapula. However, this muscle also attaches to occiput right here. This is very important. Basically, muscles attaching around occiput are important for headache. Why? Because they literally attach to head. If muscles get tight, there can be many issues. Maybe blood circulation gets decreased, maybe there's heaviness around bone, maybe there's pain. So many issues are related for tight muscles, particularly around bony structure. Does it make sense? That is why trapezius is important for headache, neck pain. Then next one is this one. This is sternocleidomastoid muscle. Sternocleidomastoid. The most of fiber of this muscle attaches to mastoid process. This is part of temporal bone. However, part of this muscle also attaches to occiput. This is very interesting to know. Actually, I will explain relationship between trapezius and sternocleidomastoid later. So please remember, sternocleidomastoid attaches to occiput. Very important. Now let's go to left side. Slightly middle layer. What is this one? This is splenius capitis. Splenius capitis, this is also neck muscle. This is on back side. That attaches to cervical spine plus occiput. So it's like sternocleidomastoid. This muscle also attaches to mastoid process plus part of occiput. Do you remember where muscle attaches? That can create tightness around bony tissue. Thus, tight splenius capitis may create headache around here, or that could be headache around mastoid process, which is on lateral part of head. See, many muscles attach to occiput or temporal bone. Then these tightness may affect for tightness around here, then headache, neck pain, tight neck, so many things. Alright, this is superficial layer, trapezius, sternocleidomastoid. This is middle layer, this is splenius capitis. I want to show you one more muscle, this one. This is semispinalis. Semispinalis capitis. This is kind of erector spinae. It's not technically erector spinae, but it's like erector spinae. This muscle attaches to occiput. Oh my gosh, so many muscles attaching around occiput. Now you see how important these muscles are for neck pain, headache, tight neck. Let's go to deep layer. Alright, this is deep layer. I want to explain three muscles in this picture. First muscle is this one. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. Rectus capitis posterior minor. Oh my gosh, this is so long name. Next one. Next to rectus capitis posterior minor, there is major. Rectus capitis posterior major. This is smaller one, this is bigger one, that is why it's minor and major. Easy to memorize, right? Next one is this one. This is obliquus capitis superior. Obliquus capitis superior. If there's superior, there's inferior. This is it. This is obliquus capitis inferior, but this muscle does not attach to occiput. Other three muscles, rectus capitis posterior minor, major, and obliquus capitis superior, attach to occiput. By the way, these four muscles, including obliquus capitis inferior, these muscles are called suboccipitals. Suboccipital or suboccipital muscles. They are tiny muscles, however, they are freaking important. Why is that? Because there are a lot of balance sensor in human body. That balance sensor is called proprioception. Proprioception, this is balance sensor of body. Like you can notice where your neck position is, where your shoulder position is without looking at, right? This proprioception is important kind of perception where your body is. Now, there are a lot of proprioceptions around suboccipitals. If this part gets tight, it's hard to maintain head position, neck position. You know, head position, neck position is important to make your head horizon. Why is that so important? Because there are a lot of sensitive, fragile, important organs around head. Look at that. There are ears, there are eyes in front of head, there are nose, there are brain, you know, so many important organs around head and neck. That is why maintaining head-neck balance is freaking important. Then these freaking important muscles attached to occipitus. Anyway, there are a lot of muscles around occiput. This is not everything. Actually, there are muscles on anterior part of occiput, but it's going to be a little bit different story, so I may skip introducing these muscles in this video. So basically, superficial muscles, trapezius, sacroiliac mastoid, middle layer, splenius capitis, semispinalis capitis, deep layer, suboccipital muscles. Now let me explain important muscle connection and nervous tissue connection. Okay, I came back to superficial layer. Do you remember this trapezius and sacroiliac mastoid? They are very close each other. See this distance? They are very close. Then I want you to focus on this tissue. This is called greater occipital nerve. Greater occipital nerve. This nerve emerges from C2 and it goes to posterior and it goes up, 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 all the way up to parietal area, which is top of head. Then this nerve goes in between trapezius and sternocleid mastoid, right here. Again, space between these two muscles are very, very narrow. What happens if you have tightness around trapezius and sternocleid mastoid? Maybe this space can be diminished. This space can be narrow. What's going to happen for this nerve? This nerve can get impingement around here. What happens if nervous tissue get impingement? There can be numbness. There can be pain around this area. This is very common thing. So many people have trauma around here. It can be from car accident. It can be from head trauma, head surgery, athletic activity like American football, martial arts, you know, rugby football. So many trauma may affect this area. Trapezius gets tight. Sternocleid mastoid gets tight. In result, greater occipital nerve have chance to get impingement. Thus, there is chance that somebody gets numbness and pain around this area. This is very important thing. Now you know this information. You can apply for maybe self-care treatment or clinical experience. I hope this anatomy and myofascial connection help your clinical experience and exercise. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.